We want to solve the system of linear equations using the elimination method, sometimes called the addition method. To solve a system of equations, we want to find the ordered pair, or the x and y value that satisfy both equations. But we should keep in mind it's possible to have no solution, or even an infinite number of solutions, to a system of linear equations. Now, to use the elimination method, the idea is to add the two equations together, and in doing so, eliminate either the x terms or the y terms. Well, if we want the sum of the x terms or y terms to be zero, either the x terms or y terms must be opposites. So the first step in using the elimination method is to put the two equations in standard form, meaning we want the x terms and y terms on the left and the constant on the right. So notice the first equation is already in standard form, so we'll go and just leave this one as is. We have 2x minus 5y equals 4. But for the second equation, we'll have to subtract 5y on both sides, so we would have 2x minus 5y equals 4. Now this is kind of an unusual case because if we take a look at these two equations, they're exactly the same. So this should already tell us about the solution to the system of equations. But let's just say we didn't recognize this. We know we want either the x terms or y terms to be opposites. Notice right now they're exactly the same. So if we want them to be opposites, we'd have to multiply one of the equations by negative 1. Let's just go ahead and multiply the first equation by negative 1 and then see what happens. We'll leave the second equation the same. So multiplying by negative 1 is just going to change the sign of everything. So we'll have negative 2x plus 5y equals negative 4. Second equation is going to stay the same. And now watch what happens when we add these two equations together. Well, the x terms and y terms are both opposites, so both sums would be 0. And on the right side, we have negative 4 plus 4. That would also be 0. So when solving a system of equations algebraically, meaning by the elimination method or substitution method, if the variables simplify out, if the remaining equation is true, we have an infinite number of solutions, and if it's false, we have no solution. Well, 0 equals 0 is always true, which indicates that the system of equations has an infinite number of solutions. And that should make sense because, remember, to solve a system of linear equations, graphically, we're actually looking for a point of intersection where the coordinates of that point would be our solution. But if these two linear equations are the same, and then we graph both, it's going to be the same line twice, and therefore the lines would have an infinite number of points in common. So it is important to be aware of what happens algebraically when there's an infinite number of solutions, as well as if there is no solution. Again, if there was no solution, this equation here would be false. But in this case, it's true, so we know we have an infinite number of solutions.